Hello everyone and welcome back to the EnTech channel. Helicopter manufacturer Bell says assembly of the prototype the company is pitching as the US Army's new Scout helicopter is more than 90% complete. Known officially as the Future Attack Reconnaissance Aircraft, FARA, the program is part of the broader Future Vertical Lift effort by the Army to modernize its helicopter fleet. Texas-headquartered Bell, a Textron company, is a finalist for that contract, along with Lockheed Martin subsidiary Sikorsky. Bell has put forward its 360 Invictus design for the FARA competition. Chris Geller, Vice President and Program Director for Bell's FARA team, tells Flight Global the first competitive prototype is more than 90% complete at a company facility in Amarillo, Texas, with one notable exception. We're doing as much as we can do without the engine, Geller says in an interview. Still missing is the turbine that will power Invictus. A GE Aviation T900 and one GE900 improved turbine engine. The Army mandated use of the ITE for all FARA designs, but GE has experienced challenges meeting the initial delivery schedule of that critical component. A representative of the Army's Program Executive Office on Aviation told Flight Global in May that pandemic-related supply and labor issues were to blame for the engine delays. The service has since pushed back the FARA CP testing timeline by a year. The missing engine limits Bell's testing of its Invictus CP. In the meantime, Geller says Bell has been using a full-scale 3P model of the engine to continue with assembly. Some testing is also occurring, using what Geller describes as a deconstructed version of the aircraft to run simulator trials at the company's systems integration lab in Arlington, Texas. The process combines digital simulators with physical components that are available to test how those systems respond to flight control inputs. Geller says he is not overly concerned by the ITE delay, noting that Bell is in regular contact with the Army and GE, and that everything is progressing along. When it comes to the FARA competition itself, the former US Army pilot is adamant Invictus is the right airframe for the job. That strategy was shaped by Geller's own experience flying the Bell 058 DKO Warrior, the now retired Scout helicopter that FARA is meant to replace. The Kiowa flew combat missions in the Army for more than four decades, from the Vietnam War to Iraq and Afghanistan. Flying fast and low, pilots of the two-seat craft performed reconnaissance and identified targets for ground troops, sometimes operating from forward areas rather than secured airfields. In Afghanistan, Kiowa co-pilots were known to directly engage enemy combatants with rifle fire and smoke grenades from the cockpit. He and Bell are betting that simplicity will make Invictus a more reliable, easy to maintain, and ultimately cheaper option. They believe those benefits will appeal to decision makers in the Army who may be wary of operationally untested technology. By contrast, competitor Sikorsky has proposed for FARA its latest design in the X-2 family, the Radarx. That aircraft features several radical design features, including two coaxial main rotors, rigid blades, and a rear-mounted propulsor for additional thrust.